dear students, hope your family and yourself are safe and healthy. Today, for the semester 3 and the subject Pharmacognosy and Phytochemistry 1, we are going to learn about a new chapter and an entirely new topic. So, for today's session, our topic is plant tissue culture. What is plant tissue culture? Actually, plant tissue culture is also defined in the field of biotechnology. Plant tissue culture, as the word denotes, tissue culture of plants is the plant tissue culture. This is unit 3 in your syllabus. In plant tissue culture, we are going to learn about the historical development of plant tissue culture, what are the types of culture, what are the methods of culture, method of inoculation. In historical development of plant tissue culture, we are going to learn about the histories of all the development of plant tissue culture, for which time the calluses, production of calluses there, mass culture medium, different culture mediums are developed by the different scientists. So this is the history of the plant tissue culture. In types of the culture, we're going to learn about the different types of culture, like callus culture, suspension culture, organ cultures, anther culture, flower culture. These all are the different types of culture. In nutritional requirement, we are going to learn about the different nutritional requirements of the plant tissue culture, because when the plant is growing externally, it gets the nutrition from the environment. But we are doing the plant tissue culture in the lab, so we have to provide the nutrition in the form of organic, inorganic elements, vitamins, plant growth regulators. Next is the growth and maintenance. In the growth and maintenance, you have to learn about the lag phase, log phase, exponential phase, senescent phase, means that phase. These are the different types of graph between the types of culture and the time taken by the culture. At last, we'll study about the applications of the plant tissue culture and one more topic, that is edible vaccine, which also includes in plant tissue culture. So one by one, we'll cover the topic of the plant tissue culture. First of all, the definition of plant tissue culture. It is a technique through which the mass of cell, you have to remember that the mass of cell is called as the callus. The word for mass of cell is the callus, and this callus is produced from an explant. Explant, what is explant? The part of plant which is used for the plant tissue culture is the explant. I have taken a leaf, then I will cut the leaf, sterilize it. So the part of plant, that leaf part, which I am using for the plant tissue culture is the explant. So you are clear about the callus and the explant. So we have to form the definition. It is an experimental technique. Why experimental? Because we are doing this in the lab artificially. An experimental technique where the mass of cell is produced from the explant. The plant, explant may be leaf, organ, it may be stem or root. The culture of plant seeds, organ, explant, protoplast on a nutrient medium under the sterile condition. Sterile condition is the most important for the plant tissue culture. So plant tissue culture is the in vitro cultivation of plant in an aseptic, sterile or controlled environment, and we are providing the neutral medium. Why we are doing? For the production of secondary metabolites, primary metabolite, and to regenerate the plant. And the callus is the mass of cell. The callus produced is directly used to regenerate the plantlets. From that callus, we can produce the plantlets, and the primary and secondary metabolites are produced. So what are the basic problems? To keep the plant cell free from microbes, to keep the condition sterile, and to ensure that the desired development of cell and organs are taken place in a provided nutrient media are the major basic problems. The most important is the growth regulator. For the plant tissue culture, we have to give the importance to the plant growth hormones. So auxin and cytokinin as provided as a plant growth hormone, but you should know that auxin should stimulate the root development and cytokinin stimulate the shoot development. And the ratio of these hormones in equal quantity will initiate the development of the callus. So as per our requirement, we are adding the plant growth hormones. Now the advantages of the tissue culture. There are various advantages of the tissue culture, is that new methods of isolation can be developed, availability of raw material. It is difficult to cultivate the plants in another season, so availability of raw material. whenever there is fluctuation in supplies, biotransformation is another process in which the functional organic compound can be modified in the living cell. So biotransformation, when a modification is done in the living cell, this is free plant. Biosynthetic pathway can be, for example, radio tracer technique, we have studied the biogenetic pathways can be studied. Immobilization of cell. Immobilization means entrapment of cell for the transportation in bio. Immobilization of cell is also the advantages. So these are the various advantages. There are also some of the disadvantages. Disadvantage, it is an expensive. Maybe sometime it is unstable. We have to maintain a lab. There is no chances of the evolution or the mutation. So these are some of the disadvantages. Now come to the history. History is given by different scientists have performed the different experiments for this. For example, in 1902, a German scientist has done the first time attended culture of isolated cell. Same, for example, I have shown you the graphical or the tabular presentation of different scientists. For example, culture and root tube development have done, sometime cruciferous species embryo culture have been done, and in some time vitamin B is introduced as a supplement and we get the production of the root tip culture. So these are the history data of the plant tissue culture. Murashigen is Coupe medium is the important medium with the higher salt concentration, which is developed in 1962. This is the complete chart. So you have to write this, which scientist had worked on which advancement and in which year. At least you should know about 7 to 8. Why we are doing plant tissue culture? We are doing the plant tissue culture because a single explant can be multiplied into several thousand plants in less than a year. A fast process as the plant tissue culture is. We can develop the disease-free plants. Tissue culture allow fast selection of cropping. These are the same as the advantages of the plant tissue culture. Now, these are the some of the endangered medicinal plants, which can be produced by the plant tissue culture. Ginkgo biloba, Gymnia silvestris, the Catharinthus roseus. So we can go to through this. Now, the fundamental utilities of the plant are the three categories: totipotency, dedifferentiation, and competency. The potential or the capacity of plant to develop the entire plant is the totipotency. Capacity of mature cell to return to the meristematic condition and development of new growing plant is the dedifferentiation. Competency means survival for the fittest. These are the categories and these are the abilities of the plants. Now, this is the short presentation by which you can understand how plant tissue culture can be done. In vitro plant tissue culture, see the source of tissue explant. We will take the tissue explant from A, then we will make a culture. And we will inoculate that culture of explant in that medium, explant culture on agar medium. Generally, agar medium or gummy mediums are taken so that jellies medium are taken so that they can be formed the shape of the culture medium. This is the explant. Then after some time, the seed develops the callus production and then plantlet regeneration can occur. And then these plantlets are transplanted into the sterile soil. What are the basic requirements of the plant tissue culture? The basic requirements are plant material, we need equipment, glassware, media preparation, sterilization, nutrient medium, culture room, optimum aeration, laminar airflow. These are the some of the requirements, and the details of the requirement I have discussed in detail with you in our online lectures. And these all are the details of the requirements. Then the aseptic conditions to be maintained, important. We can use the hot sterilization, steam sterilization, dry heat sterilization, ultra sterilization. These all are the requirements of the plant tissue culture. Nutrient media, nutritional requirement. The nutritional requirement of the plant tissue culture include inorganic nutrients, organic nutrients. Inorganic, again two type, macro and micro. Those nutrients which require larger amount, that is nitrogen, phosphorus, potassium, are the macro, and micro are the copper, iron, magnesium. Organic nutrients, vitamins is also important part, plant growth regulator, other media substance like solidifying agents, pH to be maintained, 5 to 6 different vitamin B, B1, B6 can be used as a nutrient medium. And plant growth regulator are also the important part for the nutrient medium. This proper temperature should be maintained. These are the techniques how the plant tissue culture is done. plant growth, first let me complete the plant growth regulators. Auxin, cytokinin, gibberellin, these all plant growth regulator can be used. The basic methodology technique for the plant tissue culture are the preparation of suitable nutrient media. We will prepare a medium, we will select the explant, we will sterilize that explant, we will inoculate, then incubation period up to a week, 5 to 6 weeks, 1 to 2 weeks, then regeneration. After regeneration, these plantlets are transferred to the greenhouse or the field. This is the proper technique and that are the methods. This is the complete cycle how we can do the plant tissue culture in a proper step-by-step manner. This is the regeneration of plant from the explant. How this is how the explant is taken, inoculation, incubation is done, and then plant are ready to transfer into the greenhouse. Now, in vitro culture of plant, the major steps for the in vitro, if we go line by line, for sterilization of glassware, preparation and sterilization of explant, production of callus, then proliferation of callus, subculture of callus, and the suspension culture. So one by one, we can go through that. All other is the types of culture. This is the most important types of culture. There are two types of culture basically based on the medium. If we see the medium, two types of culture, suspension culture and callus culture. And again, the suspension culture is batch culture, semi-continuous and continuous. And this continuous is open culture and closed culture. So this is the type according to the medium. Callus means mass of cells. Suspension means we'll plot that mass into the liquid medium, that is the suspension culture. This is the description for the callus culture and the suspension culture. In suspension culture, active proliferation of callus can be done or submerged in the liquid medium. Now, depending on the part used, the culture are of different types, like hairy root culture, protoplast culture, somatic hybridization. Sometimes questions come separately for the protoplast culture and somatic hybridization. So you need to discuss in detail about the protoplast culture and the somatic hybridization. The organic organ cultures are root, shoot, flower, and then the part which is used named as that type of culture, fruit culture, plant cell culture. Root tip culture, in which the roots is used, shoot tip culture, leaf culture, flower culture, anther culture, hairy culture, then hairy root culture. These are the some of the applications of the hairy root culture, then the protoplast culture. Protoplast are the plant cell with the plasma membrane but without the cell wall. So for that isolation of protoplast, two methods are used, mechanical method and enzymatic method. So protoplast culture is an important technique and important culture technique. This is the way how the protoplast culture can be done through the callus formation. Applications of the protoplast culture is same as the common application for the plant tissue culture. So the four important key points for the application of the plant tissue culture are the production of phytopharmaceuticals and secondary metabolites. Next, biotransformation means biochemical conversion. Substrate, chemical conversion in liquid, living cells produce what the product will obtain, chemically different product. So biotransformation is second one. These are the examples for the biotransformation. Then the another important, plant cell immobilization. Entrapment of cell is called as plant cell immobilization. This is also the application. Next is the genetic transformation for the transgenic plant. The plants obtained through genetic engineering contain a gene, usually of an unrelated organism. This is called as transgenes. Next is elicitor. Elicitor means organic or inorganic agents which act as accelerators. Okay, these are called as elicitors. Micropropagation, also called as clonal propagation, dealing with the ability to regenerate plant directly from the explant from a single individual cell. Artificial seed or somatic seeds can be produced by this. Cryopreservation, the preservation of cell tissue and organ in a liquid nitrogen is known as cryopreservation. And this science is also used nowadays, an important role playing in plant tissue culture. Pressing the biosynthetic pathways, generation of the novel compounds, and these are some of the important questions that can be asked from the plant tissue culture. Now, one portion that is left in the plant tissue culture is the growth and maintenance. In growth and maintenance, you have to know the different phases of the plant tissue culture, lag phase, log phase, exponential phase, how much time is taken, in the suspension culture. And one more thing is the edible vaccine. The vaccines which are edible is called edible dose, means vaccines are generally give through the injectables. So some eatable vaccines are there which are, can be produced from the plants, are called as edible vaccine. So in this chapter you should also know about the short note on the edible vaccine, and that I will provide you in the next lecture series. These are the references from where the plant tissue culture can be referred. Thank you, be safe, stay healthy, and please subscribe our YouTube channel, Fire Martin 9.